This video content can be disturbing to some audience. Hello, so today I'm going to share some yummy things of society to society, or you can say I am just ranting. So as most of the artists and authors, I am not a sociopath, just an introvert. Many people asked like why I'm so negative? Why my art is dark and gloomy? Why I have such scary dark humor? That's not how I've always been. I mean, I was not an extrovert, but I was neither an introvert, I was the kid who kinda rules the group. I had four schools and I was always the best pupil. Things looked different before adolescence. But then things happen, and I saw deep dark emptiness of the universe. I always thought everybody was good, but we're not good until we do good for them. Have you ever pointed out one flaw, boom, you are out. Maybe compared to a miserable life, it wasn't so bad, but I was a thinker. Now an overthinker, but see, thinking all the possibilities and outcomes is what bring the change and the solution to the problems. First awakening, when I was in charge of disciplinary, and I only put names of all those students who were not following, and as I am open mind and was never biased, I put my good friend's name too, and the teacher punished them. Ho ho ho. Now I laugh, but I felt bad that time I lost my friend circle, and that was the trauma I never had as a 12-year-old. I thought this was a tiny matter, and it can't affect me since I am a child who saw violence from young age, being in such surrounding. I even saw people killing each other for survival, not in TV only. Well, it was not difficult for me to make new friends, even students whom I fought till their hair falls became my friends, cause I am a popular kid, the kid who is just best in school. But things changed when I was 14 years old, somebody important died. I felt awful and so frustrated that I got into a fight with my teachers. What's more, my parents' attention has shifted. I'm at the dawn of my teens and I need affection. My teachers support me, but I am a thinker who emphasizes that all negative causes are always present, and that the negative should change, positive efforts do not count. So I'm a bit distracted with my goals and ambitions, because I've always had the best, and I want better, so that the student who most of the time scores 95 to 96 obtained only 90%. The more capable you are, more the people expect, that's what my parents yelled at me. Nobody ever asked me why I always look sad, or if I'm okay. So now F everything. Since nothing can satisfy people, I don't want to do anything, I will only follow those students who manage to pass, and enjoy, and just kinda eat, and wonder I become one of them, but still, I am unhappy. I did not know why, because I was not aware of the term mental disorder, nor did my secondary or higher education mention it. I thought it's maybe because I heard them talking bad behind my back, and they are not true, but even if I can't ignore, I want to ignore, as a teenager I do choose ignorance and friends Jean Ha Ham Sok Kadi Hai. But realizing it every day that I am ignorant, I hated myself, and was having health issues whose roots were mental issues, and my absence made me dumb in junior college, I barely managed to pass. Now another trauma occurs, my granny got a disease and everyone expect me to do nursing for her, but my parents want me to study hard, but damn, I heard each and everything my relatives said, and my mind is full of their bullshit I heard every day, and I can't concentrate on any other thing, and today my granny died. I am in misery and I have to give JE exams, well I have never prepared for JE and nada, and I know I am not gonna make it. But my parents want me to give the exam, so I am not attending my granny's funeral. I ran to my mother-in-law's home to get prepared for exam day. Well, as I said, I didn't even pass JEE, but somehow I managed to score well in NADA enough to get top 4th college of India in 2017 for architecture, but my parents don't trust China and Chennai, or maybe I am a girl. In India, almost all parents only focus on their child's future, and all they want is them to follow the idle path like doctorate or engineering, an orthodox for a successful life. No one ever even thinks about their mental state. We humans want our descendants to achieve things what we can't in our lifetime. Have you ever asked why? Listen further. I do engineering all the way from my hometown. So here the new environment, I am trying my best to please and make myself comfortable to new friends, but then I realize people want to talk to you, not to know you but to hear what you say, and use it as your weak point or to exaggerate them while bitching. Ugh, she always gets calls, his parents yell at him. They are group of damaged, or they will call you slut when you talk frankly with boys. I am already exhausted traveling 50 kilometers and no longer wants to waste my energy on two-faced people, so I stopped making fake friends or talking to dumb people while I barely talk to my parents. Yes, that was when I got paranoid. And because I neglected my mental health, I'm bad at memorizing things, I had symptoms earlier, but I was ignorant. I feel stifled to have everything within me. I am crying for no reason, and having breakout in class. Everyone looks at me with hatred because I just cry, and have a sad face all the time. Well, even I felt gross for myself. One day I told my friend what's going on with me, when she insists to tell, she asked me to share it with our homeroom teacher. Well, she was generous and I had a counselor, damn that man, he told me to focus on positive, and have a good diet, wow, I mean if I have a brain to find my negatives, I know my positives, but I can't admire a little flower in that pond of mud. People say we are the people who always have problems, and when we don't, we create them. Well, everyone knows how society is with flaws and darkness, and I don't understand why society wants to only focus on the sunshine, and not in the dark deep infinite space. From the silliest to the greatest innovations, what made human life easy, were never born from ignorance. All those scientists who were given great solution to mysteries were all skeptical, curious, they always think why this and why this not. To be honest, we should feel grateful to the people who have focused on the negative, found the problem, and vest the solution, and encourage them. Just look around. Everyone knows there is something wrong, and if only everyone starts thinking at the very moment about that problem, and for the solution, we don't have to wait for our descendants to travel back to the Andromeda Galaxy. I still have some mental issues, but I am recovering at my best, and I know I will never get cured, cause it's impossible for the world to have no problem. I believe that's why man is a special kind. One can think and question for the better, and knowing that makes me happy. Remember, ignorance is not a bliss.